We come together to celebrate Christ in our life. We seek Christ's wisdom every day. We follow the scripture, and where we all come together to build a strong foundation. Because the foundation is so important to each one of us. We come together to celebrate Christ in our technology. So today is 6 days left to Christmas. We're gonna talk about the love of God, why we should be in love with God, in love, not just love God, why we should be in love with God. And that is crucial for all of us, because we all thrive and crave love. We crave to love ourselves, we crave the love of others, and of course we crave the love of God. So how can we be, and why should we be in love with God? Well, first of all, because God is in love with us. Now, let's say that, you know, you don't believe in God, or God, you think that God doesn't exist, then how could you talk about that? Well, if God did not exist, where would the human being today be? Well, it would be just like before they learned all about God, in love with something that is supernatural, because the human being, since their existence, have within their system, God, the creator, have installed in the brain, in the heart, in the soul, and the spirit, that the need to connect to the supernatural power that is out there. And today that we're aware of this supernatural power, and we know the name of that supernatural power is called God. So if you did not know that God and you don't believe in God, you still, as a human being, is within you, and you find yourself is submitting to that supernatural power if you did not know God. So now we know for sure, especially us who have experienced God, we know that God does exist, and we know that God loves us so much, and he is in love with us. And today we want to learn why we should be in love with God, why it is important for us as a human being to be in love with God. Well, let's first understand what love is and what in love is. See, the love is one thing, and being in love is the add-on, is the when you raise your love, you raise your standard, you scale things up, you become in love. Well, the Bible says love is perfect. And this is, he gives us a model of how to love. It says the Bible says love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or hostful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and it keeps no record of being wrong. And that's a huge thing. Love, it does not keep record of being wrong. So God, if he's in love with us and we're in love with him, he does not keep record of all of our wrongs. Why? Because he's in love with us and he knows we're in love with him. And the same thing with us as a human being. To have freedom in life, we have to remember this, not to store records of wrongs, our wrongs and the wrong of others. That is a key element here in experiencing freedom in life. In order to experience this freedom, you must not be a well of wrongs. You have to be a well of love. So it does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. See, that is the love. That's the love. The love that has rejoice, and you are full of joy. That you rejoice for what? You rejoice for the truth, For when you see others are happy, when you see others are benefiting, when you see others are winning. So we have to understand what love is, because love is that feeling where it grounds you and it connects you with the supernatural God. That's what love is all about. And he continues and it says, love never gives up, never. The word never, never, it means what is eternal. You got to keep trying and trying, trying, even if you're faced off that, you know, that whoever that you want to bring your love to, and they don't want your love, and you believe that they should receive their love and you should pour their love onto them. The Bible says, love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstances, endurance. So love, God, if we're talking about love, and we know God loves us, and God is in love us, with us. So we know that God is patient and kind, because if he's in love with us, he knows he created us, and he knows he's aware that we have to evolve. We have to learn, we have to grow, and we have to scale. But we cannot learn and scale to match up with God, to meet up with him, unless what? Unless we understand love and we start generating love within us and accept God's love to us. So understanding what love is really, really important, because sometimes we might have misunderstanding what love is all about. It could be that what everyone's loving us, about everyone, we feel that we must be loved. That's what love is all about. Yes, we must be loved, and also we must love. And that is the thing I think about is, if you, let's say if someone is in love with someone else, right? And that person is not in love and does not receive that love from the person is in love. So what happened is the person is in love with the other person, let's say a couple, right? You will do everything it takes to bring the attention of that love to that person. We'll be patient, we'll follow that person, we'll pursue that person, we'll pursue their best interest. We'll do everything it takes to learn all about that person. Why? Because they're in love with them and they want the best for them. They want to show all the good things about them to that person. They learn about, you know, their schedule so they can meet up with them whenever they have a chance to. They learn about what they like, what they love, perfume, roses, chocolate. They learn about their colors. They learn. So when you're in love, you learn, you put all your efforts to learn all about that person. Why? Because you want to prove to them that you are in love with them. You want to prove to them that they are worthy of your love. They are worthy, and you are worthy of receiving their love. So being in love is something really, really great and huge, and only human can understand that. Only the human being can understand the power and how powerful it is to be in love, not to just love, to be in love. So if we look at God and how he has treated the human being since the existence, we know he's in love with us, because we look at ourselves. Let's say I am right now at this age, I'm a sinner. I've made so many mistakes in my life, and yet I'm still alive, I'm still healthy, and I recognize that the love of God to me, he's been patient and kind until I learn. And even sometimes when I learn something, and then think that I'm not gonna make the mistake again, then I'll find myself making that mistake again. And yet God is patient enough and understands that his love to me and him being in love with me, that I is gonna be kind and patient and not rude to me, in order for me to learn and scale. And same thing we do with others. Now, where the problem lies is when you're in love with someone and that person is not in love with you. What happened? As much as you pour that love and that interest into them, they resist you. They run away. They hide from you. So imagine that how you feel When you're in love with someone and that person has no interest in the love you're providing them. So imagine and think about it, how it hurts, how it feels, how rejected you feel. Well, could God feel the same way, that he's in love with you and he's in love with all of us, 8 billion, 7 billion, 10 billion, whatever that is on this earth, he's in love with all of us, and yet some of us reject that love. We run away from that love. We come up with excuses why we don't need that love. Or sometimes we could say, oh, we don't deserve this love. Yet God keeps loving us. And he loved us so much that 2021 years ago, he sent his son as a gift, the Christmas gift. The biggest Christmas gift that the world have received was 2021 years ago. And now, within 6 days, we will celebrate. We will celebrate the birth of that gift, Jesus Christ. And that gift represents the love of God, that he is so in love with us that he decided what? To send his son. And what does it say in Matthew 1:21? It says, she will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. So God loved us so much that he sent his son, Jesus, to save us from sin. What is sin? Sin is hurtful. Sin is sadness. Sin is pain. Sin is not loving ourselves. Sin is self-hatred. Sin is rejecting the world. Sin is struggling. Sin is resisting. Sin is being mad and upset. Sin is living within our head. All of this is the sin that we live within. It's because, why? Because we have separated from God's love. He's in love with us, yet in, for all these generations, we decided a human to separate from him and go look for love in the wrong places. And then he decided, God, to reconnect us with him through Jesus Christ. So in John 3:16, what does he say? He say, for God so loved us, for God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. That's how much God is in love with us, that he doesn't want to even see us perish. He wants us to have everlasting life, eternal, to be with him eternally. That is how much God loved us. That's how much God cared for us. He believed so much that with his love, that through his son and us seeing God through his son, seeing God's work through the son, Jesus, seeing the love that he's gonna show us all the way to death, sacrifice all the way to death. Why? Because God is in love with us. And is this a good reason to be in love with God? Yes. Why? In John, in 1 John 4:7-20 says, dear friends, let's love each other because love is from God. So the love we're talking about, Jesus Christ, is from God. And the word love comes from God. And the creation of this earth was all about love. The creation of Adam and then Eve, first Adam, was about love. Then God looked at Adam and said, hey, we still need to pour more love into that. So he created Eve. And together now they're showing God's love. And God looked at them and said, oh, okay, he created the Garden of Eden for them. Why? So they can enjoy it. So when you do something for your children or for someone, you buy them a gift on Christmas, you go and help others and feed, or you go to your children, buy them a house or build them a garden, anything. Why? Because you're looking on the inner you, that inside love within you, and inside in love within you will pour into your beloved one. Why? You want to see them happy. You build a garden, you invite them to dinner, you throw parties, you do all of this. Why you do that? Because the love that is inside of you, God's love, wants to see it connecting with others so you can resurrect love within them. That's why it's done. Dear friends, let's love each other. Why? Because love is from God. And everyone who loves is born from God and knows God. So when you're in love and when you love other, that means you know God, because now you know love. And he's saying that is love is born from God. And who is love? Is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is love. He is the word. He represents everything about love, everything about being in love, everything about connecting us to God, connecting us to this beautiful world that we live in. So we can what? We can live the true love and connect. What is love? Love is a feeling. What kind of feeling it is? What kind of meaning it has? The feeling of love within us gives us that sensation that we are accepted by God. It gives us the sensation within us that we are complete. It gives us that sensation with us that we have arrived as a human being, as a person. It gives us that sensation that where we feel confidence. What kind of confidence is that? That's the confidence of God within us. That's the confidence connecting to God. And that's the love we're talking about. That's why we have to return the love to God by being in love with God. Not just love God, being in love with him just as much as he's in love with us. And how do we become in love with God? Understanding and knowing why Christ came to this world. Why did he come? To bring you love. And what is love? That this love is saving you from the sin that blocks you from being in love with God and receiving the love of God and receiving the love of others. And then you become that river of love like Christ, Christ-like. And that's what's so important. It says the person who does not love does not know God, because God is love. So when we talk about love, now we understand why Jesus came to this world, why he's still with us, why he's still alive and throughout the last 2,000 years, why Jesus is still alive here. His spirit, his words, his existence, he shows up to all of us. He shows up here and he shows up there, and he comforts us, he connects us. He understands the pain we go through. And then he comes in and says, surrender, confess your sin, confess that I am your Lord. And with that, you receive what? You receive salvation. What is salvation? Is love. That's the love you receive from God, is salvation. He's telling us, you shall never perish, never. You'll have eternal life through what? Through Jesus Christ. That is the Christmas. That's what we're celebrating right now. We must understand this celebration, must connect to that. And if you've never connected with God, maybe this is the time. If you feel your heart is not allowing you to understand this, if you feel your heart is a bit hardened, and not is confusing you from surrendering and feeling that love, feeling this notion of love, and you think you're not able to let go so you can be in love. And the first person, if you've never been in love with anyone, well, the first to be in love with is God. Decide. It's a decision that you can make. And how can you do that? How do you do that? Well, salvation, right? Since Jesus came, and that's what we're celebrating right now, his birth, Christmas, he came what? To save us from sin. Well, how does he save us from sin? It's simple, very, very simple. How do you receive everlasting life? Well, you shall not perish. Very simple. Just you must believe that God is in love with you and believe that Jesus came to this earth for you to save you. And confess him through mouth, because faith is we confess it through our mouth. I confess that Jesus Christ is my Lord and Savior. He will save me, and he will save me now from sin. That's all it takes. That is all it takes. You confess it. You'll allow your heart to purge whatever darkness, whatever that you have stored, all the wrongs is stored in there. We want to right now empty it. And how do we empty this drive? How to delete all of this that is in the heart that is holding us back, holding us from self-love and loving others, holding us from understanding the love of God? That is how we do it. We confess. All you have to do is say, I confess that Jesus You are my Lord and Savior. Save me from all my sins. I confess that you died for me on the cross. And I confess you were resurrected from death to resurrect me with you. And I confess and ask to receive the Holy Spirit. That's all it takes. It's very simple. It is not about hard work. It doesn't have to, you don't have to go to Jerusalem. You don't have to go on any pilgrim. You don't have to go to a church. You don't have to do anything. All you have to do is to receive that love and for you to be open to feel the love of God in you is confessing who Christ is and understanding who Christ is and understanding why did he show up for you and why he's still here ready, open to receive you and to come and join you, merge within your heart, purge your heart, delete all the past from your heart and fill it up with what? With Christ's love, with the Holy Spirit. And with that, you're ignited. You are ignited. Say, can anything ever separate us from Christ's love? Nothing. Does it mean he no longer loves us if we have trouble or calamity? No. Or are persecuted or hungry or destitute or in danger or threatened or with death? No, that's the Christ that we know. That's the Christ that loves us so much. That's the Christ that he cares for us so much. This is in Romans 8. He goes on to explain why Christ loves us so much and how we should love him and why the love of God in us and us, we must fall in love with God. Despite all these things, overwhelming victory is ours through Christ, who loved us. He loved us. And I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love, neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today nor our worries about tomorrow. Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the earth below. Indeed, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. Is that awesome or what? Is this affirmation or what? Is this confirmation or what? How can we go wrong once we understand that nothing, once you confess and you submit yourself and you surrender to God through Christ, that's that nothing will ever separate you from that love. Nothing. It says even hell itself cannot separate us. The sky cannot separate us. Volcano, whatever nuclear weapon cannot separate us. Because God revealed himself in Christ for us. He showed us his work, who he is, how much he loved us, that he's here to heal us. And the first healing is what? Each one of us, if right now you're going Christmas, we know it's the season of love, but yet also can be a season of stress, depression. Why? It depends on what's going on in someone's life. Well, I tell you this. In order for you to really understand and know love and know God and have God right now, today, bring the healing that you're looking for. Even if you don't know God and you don't feel him in your heart, all you have to do is just once in your life, surrender, trust, and only trust God. We talked about trust. The only time you should use the word trust is God, that you trust God, no one else. So if right now you decide to trust God, trust that he loves you, and trust that he is going to reveal himself through you right now. Ask him, say, please reveal yourself to me today. Reveal yourself to me right now so I can see you, can feel you, can and help me, cleanse me as you promise. Challenge God, challenge him, say, cleanse me today. You promise to cleanse me, cleanse my heart, and fill me up with the joy you promise that you to give me free. It is free. Give me that joy. Challenge God. But you have to surrender and trust God that He will do it. Trust Him. Once you trust God, what happened? You will see God's love. Again, we're back to, if someone's in love with another person, that person is not love in love with them, he's not going to feel that love. The person who's not in love is not going to feel it, is not going to understand it, even though the person in love is in pursuit. Every time we bring gifts, we'll understand what, you know, the food that person likes, the clothes they like, the colors they like. They go out of their way to do whatever it takes. Why? To prove to that person that they're in love with them and they want their love back. Well, if God has been doing that to you and you're not feeling it, maybe it's time to just pause and take a look on the inside and say, all right, I have not experienced God's love the way He is, Nicholas is say, talking about right now. It's time for me, I want to understand it and I want to experience it. So for to do that, just surrender, trust God that He will reveal Himself to you. He will reveal Himself to you. God's love is too great to fully understand. Because it says in Ephesians, and may you have the power to understand, as all God's people should, how wide, how long, how high, how deep His love is. So even we have to pray for this understanding. You gotta ask God, say, because it just, it could be too much for us to understand or to even believe. It'll be too much to look at that love and say, yes, God, I understand it. Well, if we don't understand it, pray for it. You may have the power to understand. That is in Ephesians, that you may have the power to understand as God's people should. If you're God's person, you should have the understanding. And what kind of understanding? How wide, how long, how high, how deep His love is. You cannot get away from His love. It is everywhere. May you experience the love of Christ through, though it is too great to understand fully. So a lot of people, they go through this issue. How could that, you know, be that a person comes to this world and will die for me purposely, not by accident, not through a war, not anything? No, he comes in and say, I'm here and my mission, that I want to show you my love, I want to save you from sin, I want to fill you up with so much love that you'll be so much joyful, and for this reason, in order for you to experience this love, I must die on the cross for you. So in order to fully understand that, then you'll understand the birth of Christ. You understand what Christmas means. You understand now why you connect to God's love, so you can become Christ-like, so you can pour that love inside of you on others. And that is important. So then you will be made complete with all the fullness of life and power that comes from God. So if you want that, if you want that love, if you want that power, and He keeps telling us it's a power. What power you need? The power to understand, the power to love, the power to receive love, the power to connect with God. Where do you get that power from? Through Jesus Christ. Then you will be made complete. Yes, you and I as a human being, we will be made complete. That doesn't mean our action will be complete. No, it's who we are, we become complete. With all the fullness of life. That fullness of life. So that's why we thrive, right? We want to show off to the world, especially right now, social media. All of us want to show off on social media that we are, have fullness of life. We are attractive. We are smart. We have intelligence. We have something to offer to the world. Come look at us. I can bring whatever to the world, add value. All of us want to add value to this world, want to be there for each other, to serve each other. Well, first, in order to do that, you have to be made complete with all the fullness of life's power, what that comes from God. You have to receive it from God. You and I cannot give that to each other. That is God's gift. God's love is shield, you know, has surrounding you and keeping you safe. That's how much the love of God can be so beautiful to you. And that's what we have to understand. The understanding comes really, really important here. And I love this in Psalms 5:11-12 said, but let all who take refuge in you rejoice. Right? But let all who take refuge in you rejoice. Let them sing joyful praises forever. We don't sing it. We all love singing. Well, I mean, unless we have good, great voice, but if you don't have great voice, we still love to sing, and we love to hear singing, and we love to hear the worship and praises. So it brings what? Sing joyful praises. It brings joy. Spread your protection over them, that all who love your name may be filled with joy. So we're back to the same thing. Love is, God is what love. Christ is what, Jesus is what is joy. So in order for you to be filled with joy, you have to understand Jesus. See who Jesus, why did he come in? Why are we celebrating his birth today? Why is it important? Why is it important to connect that love? Because he is the King of joy. For you, bless the godly, O Lord. You surround them with your shield of love. So love is shield as well. It's a shield by itself. He tells us, you know, your unfailing love, O Lord, is as vast as the heavens. Your faithfulness reaches beyond the clouds. Your righteousness is like the mighty mountains. Your justice like the ocean depth. You care for people and animals alike, O Lord. How precious is your unfailing love, O God. All humanity finds shelter in the shadow of your wings. Psalm 36:5-7. Who is the shadow of his wings? That's Jesus Christ. He is. Decide to be Jesus-like. Focus on that. And in order to do that, become, during this season, this holidays, the river of love, the river of giving, the river of gifts, and the river of healing to others. Merry Christmas, everyone. I trust you all have enjoyed this and added value to your life, added some joyful moments right now where you have a new knowledge, you have your spirit right now is can connect to God, connect to Christ, and found that love you're looking for, and decide to be in love with God just as he is in love with you. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and I would like to leave you with this prayer. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Yes, give you peace. May God meet all your needs according to the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus. Go with God's blessings and enjoy this Christmas and bring joy to everyone and trust that God will deliver whatever that you've been praying for. Trust he will deliver. He has delivered it to my life and I know he'll deliver it to your life. Merry Christmas. See you next Sunday at 3 p.m. 3 Eastern time, p.m. Eastern time. God bless you and thank you for joining me and see you next day.